Hello Windows Universe, in this video we will talk about how to diagnose and troubleshoot problems with the DirectX Diagnostic Tool. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. If there are problems getting a movie or game to play properly, the DirectX Diagnostic Tool can help you point out the source. Go to the taskbar and type in dxdiag and open the DirectX Diagnostic Tool. If this is the first time that the tool has been used, it will want to make sure that the drivers are digitally signed. Click yes, and then it will check it. There are some things to check. Check the video card. Some programs run very slowly or not at all, unless Microsoft Direct Draw or Direct 3D hardware acceleration is turned on. To determine this, click on the Display tab. Then, under DirectX Features, look at Direct Draw Acceleration, Direct 3D Acceleration, AGB Texture Acceleration, and make sure that they are enabled. If not, try turning on Hardware Acceleration. Where hardware acceleration is found in your computer will vary depending on your video card. AMD and NVIDIA will allow you to adjust this from your graphics control panel. Others, you can adjust it from settings in Windows. Check the requirements of your graphics card manufacturer. If that fails, the card or the video driver itself may need to be updated. We can start by going to the Device Manager, looking for Display Adapters, right-click, and click on Update Driver. Tell it to search automatically for drivers. You can also go to the OEM website and check and download for the latest drivers. We can check for unsigned drivers. A driver that's been digitally signed has been tested by the Microsoft Windows Hardware Quality Lab for DirectX compatibility. If the diagnostic tool flags an unsigned driver, updating the driver might solve the problem. As before, you can typically find the latest driver for the hardware on the support section of your manufacturer's website. Also, try to check the game controllers. If a joystick or other input device fails to respond, it might not be installed correctly. Make sure the device shows up in the Input tab. If not, reinstall the device according to the manufacturer's instructions. If it's a USB device, then just unplug it and plug it back in. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at helping you troubleshoot your digital world. Thanks for watching and have a great day.